Honestly, dude. Honestly, guys, I'm a mug and a shirt quick. I'm not even here to. I don't even care about the games, bro. I'm just here for the good times, to be honest. Like, I like watching this type of shit, not because I want to be like, no way, Halo 4, but more because I'm going to be like, wow, that game is so fucking bad. You know? I'm just born a hater, bro. I was born a hater, what can I say? The Twitch stream is ahead on you.
Overwatch 3 incoming. This time it will be Flattery 1v1 tank 1 hero. Also, you need to pay to search for match.
Special events. Summer games. Oh. No, what is it? Special events. To be here, right? Summer game. Alright. Oh, wait, it's already started. Yeah.
Everybody, welcome to the West.
What?
We are in person, and today we've got a look at what's next in video games.
Wait, this game is always everywhere.
Live here in Los Angeles at YouTube Theater, and it feels so good to be in person with a live fan audience for the first time ever. Welcome, everybody. When I started Summer Game Fest back in 2020 from a spare bedroom, I never imagined it would grow into this. Today, the video game industry has come together to show you what's next. This is a cross-industry showcase, meaning no matter where you play games, I hope you'll discover a new game to put on your wish list. The landscape of video game events has certainly changed over the past few years, but one thing hasn't. There are a lot of great games in development, and our singular goal today is to get you excited about the future. In just a few minutes, we'll see the first extended gameplay of Mortal Kombat 1. Don't worry. Alan Wake 2, the reveal of Fortnite's next season.
No way.
And yes, we do have a very special grand finale that you're not gonna want to miss.
GTA 6?
But let's get right to the games and gameplay. The first reveal is something you're not expecting, which makes it that much more exciting. Here we go.
Ubisoft! Oh my god!
Cursed. The prince has been kidnapped and taken to a forbidden land. All hope rests with us, the Immortals, to rescue him and save the Empire. But we weren't prepared for what was coming next. Then again, they weren't prepared for me.
The sound goes hard. The game though, absolute garbage. If this song is not playing while I'm playing the game, I'm not interested.
In these times of darkness, hope is the only thing that keeps us fighting. I will fulfill my destiny and save the kingdom.
I mean, I'm sure There's like three or four people in the chat who are probably proud about this, you know? Kudos for you guys.
There's a little surprise. Prince of Persia: The Lost Crown is coming in January 2024, a brand new action-adventure platformer in the iconic series with deep combat, some huge boss fights, and of course, incredible
platforming. Do people actually care about Prince of Persia?
Bringing a modern take on the legendary franchise.
Is there anyone who, like, I'm curious, is anyone here interested in playing this game at all?
Summer Game Fest. All right, let's move along to another iconic video game franchise that just celebrated 30 years. That's right. It's time for Mortal Kombat 1.
Wow!
Couldn't keep you waiting on this one. It has been 4 years since MK11, and ever since, Ed Boon and the team at NetherRealm have been hard at work on the most ambitious MK yet that reboots the series into a new era timeline. And it's coming this September. Everyone has been asking, what does it look like? Who's on the roster? How do the new cameo fighters work? Well, now it is time for combat. No spoilers, but this video is literally insane. Here is an extended first look at the story, gameplay, and yes, of course, the fatalities of Mortal Kombat 1. Let's do it.
I have had enough of you.
Then go before I put you down.
Fight.
What? That was a bit corny, not gonna lie. That was a little bit corny, I'm not gonna lie.
Today, you have proven worthy of joining us. Come, there are other champions I must gather.
What do you want?
Sento. It's my family blade.
Sento's mine, and I won't give it up without a fight.
Oh my god! Jesus!
To one here. Who are you again?
Lord Liu Kang, protector of Earthrealm, god of fire.
What the fuck? I mean, this looks sick. For what it's worth.
Skills, Raiden, but you're inexperienced.
Whatever experience I lack, I make up for in heart.
If your disease becomes known, you will be banished. I only want what's best for you.
Or do you secretly covet my throne?
Wasn't that crazy thing with someone like fucking... Holy! looks good though, right? Like, it looked good.
I mean, that was pretty good, right, guys?
Yeah, that was pretty good. I'm not gonna lie, it was pretty good.
The thing is,
I'm not a Mortal Kombat fanboy.
To tell you more, I am so honored to welcome to Summer Game Fest.
I'm not a Mortal Kombat fanboy, so like, for me, it does nothing.
Loyal to the same franchise and fan base. For me, it does nothing. Please join me in welcoming to Summer Game Fest.
But it looks really good. Like, if I was a Mortal Kombat fan, I'll be bat chesting.
Congratulations. They love you. All right. Well, Ed, first of all, thank you for that incredible world premiere. We got to see all the gameplay of MK1. And everyone just wants to know more about this because, first of all, this is in a it's MK1, right? It went from 11 to 1. So tell us about this. Is it a new timeline?
Yeah. I don't know how many people have seen the ending of Mortal Kombat 11. Liu Kang basically was kind of graduated into
spoilers, right?
And he created a brand new universe. And this universe, this is why we're calling it Mortal Kombat 1, is because this is the beginning of a new timeline. A number of these characters you've seen before, but they're told in a completely different story. And so Sub-Zero and Scorpion are brothers now, and there's all these things that were rivalries before are now allies, and so mixing the whole thing up, so we're just kind of rebooting, and that's what the one is for.
Well, it looks incredible. Everything we saw there was, you know, in-game gameplay, the cinematics look incredible. I know the team has been working for 4 years on this, but the thing we got to talk about are these cameos, because we saw some pretty amazing stuff there. Now, so tell us, how does that work? You have your sort of your main, you know, character that you'll pick, and then I know you also have a separate kind of cameo menu, so you pick sort of a pair when you start the game?
Yeah, normally in a fighting game, you'll see a roster, basically, you know, where you select your character. After you do that, there's a second roster of characters, which are a whole new, completely different fighters that are the cameo fighters, and these fighters actually, they will join the fight, but they
blank squares there.
Yeah, so it's kind of like imagine yourself with Sub-Zero, but you have some of Jack's moves, and you can call him out. You can do it multiple times, as you saw in the gameplay. You know, so you can you can basically combine these two characters. All the characters can be combined with all the cameo fighters, and that's where you see. That's where the players kind of.
I mean, that's cool, though.
In.
But like,
they can actually customize it.
Isn't this like a thing that people do already?
You know,
in other fighting games.
Well, so how does that work? So you're in gameplay. You have your main. You have your cameo. How do you summon them? Is it time based? Like, how often do they come into? It's not a tag team thing, right?
Exactly. And you're basically summoning them. It's just one button pushes basically summoning, but they have a variety. So you can go, you know, push that button with towards and it'll do a different move.
The game isn't
down,
fun anyways.
Do a different move. Okay. And so the combination.
This game's not fun.
Oh, I see. So you can bring them in a combo. Almost.
Exactly. Okay. Exactly. And you see there's like a meter up on top, which is basic. That'll limit
sure,
so
like,
you can't obviously fire them.
I mean, I don't know, man. I don't play Street Fighter, and I don't
call,
play like Mortal
them
Kombat,
much
so my opinions are relevant here.
And they have, you know, like in the middle of a combo, they'll have a lot of, you know, basically a whole arsenal of their moves. So Sonya you saw come out there. Sometimes you'll see them appear twice in there.
It's amazing. So time-based, they come out, and then obviously as you go through, you revealed some of them there, but is it a different set of characters that'll be in the cameos? Are there some repeats from the main roster? How will that work?
Yeah. Some of the characters are going to be available as cameos as well as the main roster fighters. You can play Sub-Zero with Sub-Zero, right? You can play, same thing with Scorpion. But a lot of our cameo fighters are kind of like nods back to our first game. So you'll notice Sonya and Kano and Jax are in their kind of older costumes. And
I mean,
so
it looks all right, man. I feel like I'm only because I'm just hating
like,
for hating.
Really surprised with. I think
is he that? Is he that dog
Goro,
shit?
Yes, Goro pops
in there.
Yeah. Exactly.
So there's kind of really digging into the old Mortal Kombat games as far as getting.
Is it just a fighting game? Yeah, but like,
really
what do you expect, man? An FPS from Mortal Kombat?
Feel, you know, kind of nod to the old games.
Well, speaking of nine of the old games, let's talk. You confirmed, I think, or it's at least known, that Jean-Claude Van Damme is actually going to be in this game as Johnny Cage.
Homelander and Only Man have been leaked in the DLC.
People don't know the story. I mean, Bloodsport was such an inspiration for Mortal Kombat, so he finally is
that's
now.
Sick, though, that's true.
It's a huge first full circle moment. You know, the first Mortal Kombat game, we originally wanted to be Van Damme, the video game, and that never really worked out. So I can't tell you how many times over the last 30 years we've tried to get him You know, we were this close, yeah, like four or five times. And so finally we got him, and he's doing the voices too.
Wow.
So you're going to hear Jean-Claude, his voice doing Johnny Cage lines and stuff like that. We're really excited about it.
Wow. Well, I know the team has been working so hard in Chicago to build this through COVID, and it's coming out in September, so we don't have to wait long, right?
That's right. COVID,
this,
that's like old news, man.
This has been a very difficult secret to keep, yeah, over the last 4 years. And so, but we could not be more excited in terms of getting players' hands on it. And, you know, throughout the summer, we're going to be showing a lot more content, a lot more characters, a lot more cameo characters, you know, so there's a lot of reveals that are coming up.
Amazing. Well, Ed, thank you so much for giving us the first look at MK1. As you said, this weekend people will be playing it, press and media, so we'll be seeing lots more coverage, lots more characters to reveal on the main roster and cameos. Ed Boon, thank you so much. First look at Mortal Kombat. Awesome. Thanks. Amazing. So excited about that one. All right. Next up, it's been a fun couple weeks for action RPG fans with the release of Diablo 4, which is truly fantastic. Another big and anticipated ARPG is Path of Exile 2 from Grinding Gear Games, who have faithfully been updating and patching the original PoE since its release in 2013. We haven't seen anything on the sequel in over 2 years, but that changes right now. Here is your first look at a raw gameplay capture from Path of Exile 2, a sequel that pushes the engine and gameplay to a new level.
I feel like they say that about every game, though.
Where are the guards? Hey, you! What's going on?
I feel like the problem is so far that these games aren't my thing, you know? Like I don't like this. I don't play these games. I don't play fighting games either so far, you know? What are the Nomi chat saying?
There's more coming in July. Last week marked the release of Street Fighter VI, a game we featured last year at Summer Game Fest. Well, the team at Capcom has an important update to share with you right now.
The fuck?
I am the Advanced Artificial Intelligence, Leviathan. Welcome to Bikitoa Island.
Oh, what the fuck? What the fuck is this?
I'm guessing Ryu from Street Fighter facing off against a dinosaur probably wasn't on your bingo card for today's show. That Street Fighter cross Exoprimal collab will launch in the fall,
cool, I guess,
coming out on July 14th.
Right?
But guess
cool,
what, guys? That may actually not be the craziest collaboration on the show today. Check this out.
Oh? Among Us is
nothing more powerful than imagination.
No way, Nicolas Cage, batches!
We can shape the fabric of reality, transforming everything you may think you know.
That's right, Nicolas Cage is coming to Dead by Daylight in July. I mean, I don't know how these things happen, but I figured the easiest way to find out is probably to go right to the source. This man's bold creative choices have earned him an Academy Award and a few memes on the internet across more than four decades of incredible films. Please join me in welcoming to Summer Game Fest, Nicolas Cage!
No way! He's a peace guy.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you. Happy to meet you.
Nick, I gotta say, welcome to the video game world.
Oh, wow, yeah, thank you. I'm so happy to be invited to your very, very cool club.
Finally, I mean, I gotta say, this is such a crazy, unexpected collaboration. I gotta understand, how did this come about? I mean, some people be like, oh, maybe he'll show up in Fortnite, maybe he'll be in a Hideo Kojima game, but Dead by Daylight, I mean, how does this happen?
Well, it's a museum of horror, right?
Yes.
And when I make movies, one of my favorite genres is horror. And in this, and in that genre, there's a character, a murderous ghost named Sadako, who I think is amazing. And she made an appearance in this game, so that was good enough for me.
Okay. That's what's fun is you're playing one of the survivors in this game. And it's cool that, you know, it really is this museum of horror. Michael Myers, you said all these different characters all coming together. And you, do you play yourself or who do you play?
So I play this heightened, exaggerated version of a film actor named Nick Cage. He's going to a location thinking he's making a movie, and instead he wakes up in the fog. And in the fog, he's surrounded by crows and serial killers, and it's rather amusing. And there's something about it that I think, as a survivor, is like a bonding experience. It's a bit like hide and go seek. You have your three other teammates who are survivors with you, and it's teamwork. You're working together to pull through, and I like that. And so that was a large reason for wanting to do it as well, that feeling of bonding with your friends.
And you're fully in for this? I know we heard your voice in there, so you recorded lines for it and everything?
No idea.
I want you to know when you're playing the Nick Cage survivor, I even have when you're choosing your skins, I even say, always remember to dress to match your talent. I want you to know that you're with me, that we're one, that we're fused. So it was important to me that everything I do, everything I say, from the screen to the ground, down to the most minimal, exasperated expression of a sigh, whatever it is, it's my voice, so that we are fused.
All right. Fully method, Nick Cage. I love it. I mean, this is so fun. This game, as you said, is such an awesome kind of, you know, collaboration with so many different characters. For you, I mean, how did you find out about Dead by Daylight? Do you know much about the video game?
Somebody
world?
Very important in my family is a Dead by Daylight enthusiast.
Okay.
And that really put the hook in. Ha, pun intended. See, Dead by Daylight to me was an opportunity to branch out. I've never been invited into this space before.
Yeah.
I'm always looking for new adventures. So this to me was like, wow, I can make a whole new audience, meet a whole new audience.
Wait, that's literally
and branch
what
out
I feel.
On this Dead by Daylight adventure. I didn't say it took me nothing but a split second to say yes. And speaking about split seconds, what I noticed, excuse me, sinuses, allergies. What I noticed was that every move you make when you're doing this, when you're in the gaming space, it's timed down to the split second. It's a very immersive experience when you're acting out in this space, because every move, every grunt, every sigh you make has to be timed perfectly with the gamer's move. So that was something that I learned from this, and I'm always looking to learn something.
Well, we love having you in the video game world. We want to see Nick Cage in more games.
Thanks, guys.
Nick, thank you so much.
You.
Hopefully the first fatty. Nicolas Cage, great to see you, man.
Awesome.
There you go. Lock it in. Now, for all of you who want to play Nick Cage in Dead by Daylight, the chapter officially comes out on July 25th on PC and console, but PC players can try it earlier by downloading the player test build on July 5th. And here's an exclusive first look at Nicolas Cage in Dead by Daylight.
It barely looks like him. Wait, it doesn't even look like him.
Feel free to click on this subscribe button so you got a quick prize available, huh?
Wait.
Damn right I made it.
Dude, it doesn't even look like him.
Hey, anything goes here at Summer Game Fest. All right, thank you very much, Nick. Now, lately we've been seeing an incredible number of video game adaptations, but back in 2019, The Witcher on Netflix, inspired by the Witcher book series, showed the potential of well-done adaptations, and later this month, Season 3, Volume 1 arrives, and now it's time for the world premiere of the trailer, introduced by Henry Cavill and the cast.
Hello, Witcher fans. We are all gathered here today to share something with you.
Be sure to tune into The Witcher Season 3, Volume 1 Volume 1 debuts on June 29th, only on Netflix.
Get ready to watch the world premiere of our brand new trailer for Season 3 of The Witcher.
Thanks for tuning in to the Summer Games Fest and enjoy the trailer.
Didn't The Witcher now dog shit?
Neutrality. It won't get you a statue. But it'll certainly help in keeping you alive. I won't abandon Ciri.
Neutrality has consequences too.
Right. Well, that's deeply worrying.
Everything that's happening, it's all connected. And she's at the center of it.
No one cares that in my boys anymore.
There is no hiding her from it.
I mean, I don't know anything about this job, dude. I'm sure you guys are pissed.
Are you sure about this?
Are you?
Pokemon in the winter.
Foretell an even more menacing future.
Stunning embrace.
The Witcher is only good because of Henry Cavill.
I understand, Ryu.
Man, this new game looks like shit, man. Not realistic enough, if you ask me.
We're witches.
Is that so?
Yeah, it feels like an Unreal Engine 4 game.
I'll never get over how cute they look for monsters. And they're like, no, please don't hurt me. And then wow. Fangs. Just like a boatload of fangs. All up in your business.
He's right behind me, isn't he? Dude. Okay, never mind. I'm not opening that shit anymore. I learned my lesson. Hold on. There we go. What is this? What is this? What is this?
Engagement.
I mean, I'm not gonna lie, it looked kinda shit, not gonna lie. I mean, I think it's like, I don't really like VR, to be honest. I think VR is like a failed technology, and I don't think it will ever do well. Me personally, I don't like VR, so every single time I see VR games and shit, I think they're all cringe.
No choice. The root will destroy everything.
It's just, I feel like VR games are just not there yet, you know? I could buy a VR headset or buy a computer, you know?
No turning back after this. You sure?
What is this, by the way? What is this? With this, I feel like here's the thing. It's so hard for me to remember these games because they all kind of look the same. You know? Like, if you told me what I just saw, I just couldn't tell you what I just saw. You know?
All right, we have much more Summer Game Fest to come, including a first look at the gameplay of Alan Wake 2. The world premiere.
Like, I'm sure it's a good game. I'm sure it's a good game. It's just I can't like see. I can't like
more surprises for you.
I can't spot a difference between this and the other game.
Gaming on TikTok. On TikTok. Hashtag
gaming on TikTok.
I want to welcome everyone co-streaming the show live on TikTok, Twitch, YouTube, and other platforms. For those of you on Twitch, we also have a special
Warframe Twitch drop. Guys, #gaming on TikTok.
A free Steinax Warframe for watching more than 30 minutes of the show. Now, speaking of surprises, another legendary gaming hero is set to return later this year in a brand new game built from the ground up in a style that I think is going to get this fan base and longtime fans of video games very excited. Here's another Summer Game Fest global game announcement. Oh. New thrills with a classic feel.
Another Sonic? A new Sonic? Tails? You play as Amy? Wow. Yeah, I don't want to shit on it though, but I feel like the graphics look very wonky. Like, it looks a little wonky, though. Who's this?
My cock exploded from this! Finally, more Sonic games!
Classic Sonic that's bound to appeal to new and legacy fans. This past April, Honkai Star Rail launched,
amazing,
and as you're about to see, the game is bringing an exciting new character.
Feel free to click
space
on this subscribe
fantasy
button
RPGs.
So you got a Twitch Prime
However,
available,
you don't just
huh?
have a new peak for current players, but also
the Ultra Holy
Baseball
13 is
Holland,
thanks for
on
the eight.
PlayStation. Take a look.
I wish this universe had a few more things to do. Don't you get bored running across the map every day?
Empty wires, they're showing a silence.
Trailblaze, back from duty. Mission one accomplished.
Whoa!
I can't wait.
I love getting input. Away, wow, wow, yow. Thank you, yow, yow.
Starting. Great. Let me get warmed up. Strike first.
Yeah, I don't really care about Genshin Impact, to be honest.
Feel free to click on this subscribe button.
Yeah, I don't really care about Genshin.
Genshin Impact makes me want to do.
No way, the new character is a
An Empire's Guard in the game,
wow.
No way.
That's like every other character in the game.
Can you let me have some fun this time?
Damn, bro, this shit making me tired as fuck.
At the speed, too slow.
What the fuck happened in the The bite trick just fucking died, holy shit.
Later this year on PlayStation. All right, inspired by the story of Pinocchio, Lies of P is a Soulsborne-like game from the team at NeoWiz, which is coming to Game Pass, PlayStation, and PC this year.
Wait, that's not Genshin?
Well, exactly when, we have news to share with you on its release.
Wow,
this brand new
the
trailer.
Graphics are really impactful.
Wait, that wasn't a Genshin game?
Geppetto's
they all look the same, bro.
We need your help.
And then why is the microwave broken?
What's this? Woman Alchemist?
Je t'ai rencontré sans plus mort. Et tu n'as rien.
He looks like you. No, he doesn't look like me. He doesn't look like me, losers. British beer! A
British!
I kneel. He has the same hair. You have the same hair as him? No, I don't now. I haven't even seen his face. It doesn't look too bad, Loki. Looks cool.
Listen, pal. Nice landing, but let's not make it a habit.
Oh my god, you had to add that in. You had to add that in. You really, that doesn't look like me, bro. They had to add it in. It was like, oh my god, this looks sick.
That's
what
right,
the fuck?
Demo
and they had to
Rise
add the,
P
oh, I am not a morning person. Like, dude, oh my god. And no one wants to hear Marvel dialogue, bro. No one wants to hear it, man. No one wants to hear it. We're all tired of this.
Visually stunning new game based on a classic manga with a story and world created by one of the most celebrated anime artists of all time. This is one of those games that I feel
that
lucky
demo?
To reveal for the first time here at Summer Game Fest. And I think you'll be pretty hyped.
Wait, is that demo this game?
Gameplay all built in Unreal Engine 5. Here we go.
Fuck it, dude. Give me a game that is just Marvel lines over and over and over. Please. What are we in Mexico? Dragon Ball.
the average day in Arizona.
That was hard though. Sandland.
ちょっと運転させてくれよ。もうやめなさい、王子。こんな人間の機械。いいぞ。やってみるか。いいのか。
Cool, I guess.
Sandland, get ready to become an unlikely hero in an adventure where you don't need to be
nice
human to save humanity.
Why don't you back up with a source?
My source is that I made it soon. A fuck up.
Independent games are such an important part of the industry, and one thing that's very important to us at Summer Game Fest is supporting those creators as well. After the live show, stay tuned for Day of the Devs from IM8Bit and Double Fine with some incredible indie game reveals. Now, one of the biggest independent publishers is Annapurna Interactive. And later this month, as part of Summer Game Fest, they'll be revealing a number of ambitious new projects. Let's see how many you can figure out in this little tease.
Oh my God, no way! It's straight two! Oh, this is what we're waiting for! No shot! Straight two? Never mind, it's not even straight two to kill me. It's not even a straight two, man. You can say this is straight up garbage. Got him.
Wonder what that was at the end. We'll find out later this month. All right, next, we're stepping into the world of Throne and Liberty, a free-to-play PC and console MMORPG from NCSoft and Amazon Games with an always-changing environment, massive scale, PvPvE, and the ability to transform into creatures
Wowzers.
That cross land, sea, and air. Here's a look at Throne and Liberty.
What is this?
You think you're gonna announce out?
No, I don't think so.
Our guiding star has shattered.
I think in that game, Sally died, man. Castle!
An ancient evil searches for these lost fragments, destroying anything in their path. You must find them. Harness their power.
That should look like the battle pass.
Put down this threat once and for all.
I mean, it's all right, I guess. Their storm is coming. I mean, like I said, it's another one of those games that looks cool, but I will never, like, after this trailer's done, I'm not gonna remember a single thing from this trailer, you know? Sure, whatever, you know? Sure, whatever.
Looks great. I also want to say hello to everybody watching on Steam right now. I'm sorry we don't have any free Steam decks for you right now. But on June 19th, Steam Next Fest does return, giving fans a chance to try out hundreds of new in-development games. One of them is the free-to-play medieval fantasy sword-fighting game Warhaven from Nexon, which lets you transform into supernatural immortals. Here's a new look.
This looks like the other game. This looks exciting like the other game.
I have a Neanderthal in a chat. We have an ice dweller in the chat. Let me get rid of this ice dweller.
What shit is this?
Wait, isn't this the cunts who are trying to DMCA Dark and Darker? But it's a war worth fighting. Yes? Well, fuck this dude. Never mind. I don't care. Fuck this guy. Not interested. And we keep on fighting. What is the chat saying? What is it? What is the Twitch chat saying about this? Next up, never again. Same game, lol. Pay to win. Certified Lord moments. This looks like it does look exactly like the other game too. Like even though I'm not saying that, you know. You know what? I'm gonna be a hater, bro. Fuck it. Let me follow this shit. How long did I hop? This is not. No way! Jacksepticeye! No Markiplier reaction? Unlucky. Wow! Party animals! I don't know much about this game, to be honest. Yo, Ipin Cupid, this for 2 months, thank you very much.
Pilgrims, summer is coming, and with it, a lot of cool stuff will make its way to Dying Light to Stay Human. Get ready for darker, more dangerous nights and roaming volatiles, complete with improved
parkour,
rolling out with the next update in June. Then, right after that, we'll kick off an event season like you have never seen before. Trust me, for one of them, you will want to get your butt barbed wired. Very soon, you will get the deadliest summers to date.
Oh. Oh my god, another dog shit game, no way!
No way, furry shit! I mean, no, am I scratched? The Game Pass. Yeah, the Game Pass is goated. Yeah, the Game Pass is goated, bro. I can't shit on the Game Pass. The Shake Pass is goated as fuck, bro. $10 for like every single fucking game you can think of? Yeah, I think so. Yeah, I think so.
Welcome back to Summer
Dude,
Game Pass.
Nobody cares about these trash games. Just show us Garnet Phone Sex Update already.
And Engine, Neo Cortex's right-hand guy in Season 1. Now, it's time to change the topic and descend into madness. Joining me is a guy who was last on stage at the Game Awards 2021 to announce Alan Wake 2. He's come all the way from Finland. Please welcome from Remedy, Sam Lake.
Alan Wake guy. Be honest, I wanna play Alan Wake games. They look. I don't know. Are the Alan Wake games any good, Chatters?
Thank you.
Well, we are so excited because when you announced Alan Wake 2 at the Game Awards, you said 2023. We are in 2023. It's coming this October, and we are so excited.
I should play the first one.
It's been a long time coming for fans and for you. 13 years since the first Alan Wake. So tell us a bit about what can we expect in the sequel.
It's been quite a journey, yes.
Yeah.
Alan Wake 2 is Remedy's first survival horror game. We have two playable characters. It's a 50-50 split between them. They are on their own separate terrifying journeys through two different worlds. and yet it's all connected. Mm. And the player gets to switch between them at given points in the story as they choose.
Yeah, we saw, obviously, at the PlayStation event, you revealed Saga, the second character. Tell us a bit about her. She's in Bright Falls, and she's sort of living a narrative that Alan has written. Is that right?
Well, that's a good question to ask into this. So, yes, we have Alan Wake, our title character, of course, trying to escape from the nightmare dimension of the dark place.
Yes.
And then we have Saga, our new hero, FBI agent, coming to the Pacific Northwest, small town of Bright Falls, together with her partner, Alex Casey.
Okay.
I like Finnish accents.
They're somehow linked in some way, right?
They are coming to investigate
a
series of ritualistic murders.
Okay.
And very quickly, the investigation turns into a nightmare when they discover pages of a horror story. Maybe written by a certain missing writer.
By the initials AEW.
and this horror story starts to come true around them.
Interesting. So obviously it's, you know, Alan is still going to be playable in the game. You're going to experience his journey. But Saga, this is sort of new character.
Man, I have nothing to say about this game, to be honest. It looks all right.
50-50. Do they have
Alan Wake is decent all the time.
I think you can play them in sort of different sequences or orders if you want, right?
I can't hail this game.
We go into the experience playing as
they didn't show gameplay, did they?
And it's a sequel, but it's also a standalone experience. We are not expecting everybody to do homework if they have not played the original game.
Yeah.
This can be enjoyed as is. Saga doesn't know anything about the lore, about the supernatural in this world. She will be going in very quickly. She has to learn to survive. And with that, all the players will be on that journey with her. And then we open up the experience so that you can hop to play Alan Wake in the dark place as he's trying to find his way out. And you can keep on playing as Saga in the Pacific Northwest as the investigation
goes on.
And you are free to switch between them. There are a lot of connection points in many surprising ways, but there is no right way to play through this. You can choose. You can go on as Alan all the way close to the end, or as Saga, or you can keep hopping between these two sides of it.
Well, you're always so good at kind of telling challenging, interesting narratives in unique ways. I mean, Remedy's always been known for that, and you especially, so we can't wait to see how these stories intertwine, I'm sure, throughout the experience. Today, though, I know you brought with you some gameplay of Saga's adventure. We're just going to see a raw segment of the game, right?
Yeah, raw gameplay for the first time ever. This is early on from the experience.
They're hyped, Sam. They're ready for it.
No, this guy's just telling a little bit too much.
So tell us, what are we going to see?
Oh, my God.
Supernatural forces of darkness have brought the murder victim, in this case, back to life as a monster. And Saga is outside Bright Falls at Cauldron Lake.
Holy fuck, dude, shut up! Just show the thing.
With that, let's take a look at raw, unedited gameplay from Alan Wake 2. Thanks, Sam.
Thank you.
Oh, wow, this looks nuts. And this game looks really cool, though.
Sounds like somebody's home.
Amazing, amazing. Can we go one game with a Marvel one-liner? I'm so tired and sick of hearing it. I don't want to hear it. I'm over it. He's right behind me, isn't he? Gets jumped by the fucking squirrel.
Christ.
What the fuck? Dear jump scare. Oh shit!
Still coughing.
Whoa.
He's right behind me, isn't he?
Stolen his art!
I'm not fed. No way.
Says the person that spammed Marvel one-liners on cooldown.
Nightingale.
Wow, this is not how I expected my weekend to go. Yeah, but if I make a game that makes cringy one-liners, it will be good cringy one-liners, not like, huh? No, what's like a weird one-liner like that, like the same one-liner of like fucking. Oh, my brain farted. Give me a second. Did I just do that? You know, for me, it will be more like, what are we? Some sort of
the
Alan Wake.
The heart is clearer now, legible. I knew it would be here, like I saw it in a dream.
Like a bite.
I'm glad you're on this case with me, Anderson. Killer left a message.
It's for us.
We were all trapped in a horror story.
This
horror story wanted us dead.
This is good though, right? Like, can we agree?
There's something I'm forgetting.
This looks really good.
Something important. Something's not right.
Yeah, this is good. I don't know. I'm looking forward to this. I am looking forward to this.
A long time coming, but Alan Wake 2 looks incredible. Thank you to Sam and Remedy for that first look at gameplay. Now let's get a first look at the co-op campaign of Warhammer Space Marine 2 from Saber and Focus.
We're facing a Tyranid splinter fleet. They engaged us on two planets, Avarax and Kadaku. I'll be straight with you.
Warhammer!
I have my reservations about your reinstatement.
Yeah, I'm excited for fucking, what's his name?
No, Captain.
Tyranids!
My pledge is eternal service.
Xenos inbound! Eviscerate this abomination! Come forth and be slaughtered. Open the gates.
That was hard though.
See if you can slay more Xenos for the Chiron. I thought a piece of that statue would offer more sport. Hold them back, damn it!
I mean, it looks good, I guess. What's this? What the fuck? So it's like Game Simulator.
Beautiful indie game, yes, Your Grace, Snowfall. Now it is time for another global game announcement, and this one comes from the minds of Saber Interactive, Focus Entertainment.
I'm not even kidding.
And yes, horror master John Carpenter.
I'm not kidding. I'm looking forward for Alan Wake.
A brand new story.
Ironically.
And looks like a heck of a lot of fun.
Alan Wake looks really good. What is this? Please be another horror game. I love horror games. Okay.
We gotta be ready.
What's this?
Nobody half-asses it this time. Ruby.
Ugh.
Oh.
On my mark. 5, 4, 3.
Shot through the heart, and you're to blame. You give her a bad name.
John Carpenter's Toxic Commando. Yup. They don't make games like we used to. Nothing much to say. I'm not exactly bat chest about it, you know?
More unexpected collaboration. John Carpenter and Saber with Toxic Commando. That looks tons of fun. You guys think any of those zombies made it? I don't know. All right. Well, this August brings the long-awaited full 1.0 release of Baldur's Gate 3. And today,
Baldur's
a new
Gate
member
3?
Is joining the cast. We're about to see the reveal of Lord Enver Gortat.
Actually, good game.
Mechanical
legit
army
same exact assets reused over and over again.
He's voiced by familiar name.
What the fuck is Baldur's Gate? The sequel to Divinity 2.
Enver Gortash, swearest thou by Baldurin's blade to defend the citizens of Baldur's Gate enemies within
Divinity 2 is a
without
fucking banging game. The problem is, like, it's pretty, like, generic in every other aspect.
The people of Baldur's Gate granting me complete power over them. A new age is upon us. Gods have mercy on those who would stand in our way.
Yeah, I mean, honestly,
a mad dog understands the yank of
I'm
the
looking forward to this game, Loki.
Master, but it cannot be an equal. You can be my equal. There's an old wisdom. A brittle alliance can never be mended. It can only break. I want to lead this city to glory, not scorch its earth.
Friends, allies, to my side. Let us usher in a new dawn. This city is mine!
I'm not ready to call you enemy. What do you say? Shall we be allies?
I'm pretty sure this game... Wait, is it few release on the Hour 31?
You said it was under control.
It isn't you I answer to.
Yeah, it's a D&D game, Chatter. It's a D&D game. It's a game you play with friends. It's a D&D game, you know?
Baldur's Gate 3 is on track, Sven tells me still, for the end of August, and we can't wait to check that out. All right, this fall, Marvel Games and Insomniac are set to bring Spider-Man 2 exclusively to PlayStation 5. Sounds like you guys are a little hyped, so to tell us more is Brian Intihar, game director at Insomniac.
No
Brian,
way.
Thanks for coming by. I know you guys are deep in development. First of all, it looks like we have some... fancy art behind us. Is this the box?
This is the box art. This
okay.
is, you know,
ooh.
This is it. Here it is. I mean,
has two on the box for a reason, because this game features two Spider-Men, so we're really excited about it.
Absolutely. Peter and Miles, we're so excited about this experience that you guys are doing with these sort of two characters. We saw some great gameplay at the PlayStation Showcase, but I want to talk about the two
guys. Can I go 5 minutes without saying something fucking great?
There may be more.
There are more out there, I
promise. Two main ones, but we have some new art to show of, obviously, Kraven. We got the reveal at the PlayStation event, so tell us a bit about him and how he factors
in. Kraven's very different from any character we've done. He's not, he's not powered by magic or, tech. He's just the best hunter in the world, and he's coming to New York for his greatest hunt. And what's better than all of the Marvel characters that live in New York City? So Peter, Miles, and others, he's on the hunt.
And others, ..
Yes, yes.
But Venom also, obviously, Symbiote is a part of this whole story.
And others, maybe Iron Man.
There you go. Good reaction to the art.
I'm glad you're happy.
I don't know how much you're going to tell us about Venom. Is this, is this an Osborn Venom? Can you tell us, what's the origin of Eddie Brock Venom? Or?
It is not Eddie Brock.
Okay.
It is not Eddie Brock.
Okay.
Our goal was to tell an original story, something you haven't seen in the comics or the movies yet. Obviously, we love Venom for a reason.
Yeah.
All those things you love about the character are going to be there. But how the story plays out, who is Venom, you have to play the game to see how it goes.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow. Okay. There's a bit of a tease. Now, obviously, the symbiote is a big part of the gameplay. And one of the things I think we were all struck with the footage that you showed at the PlayStation Showcase was, how that is going to really impact the gameplay when you're playing as, Peter. So tell us a bit about that and how, the gameplay is going to be dramatically different.
Yeah, I mean, I think you saw it.
Uncle Ben is Venom.
The strength and even the transformation of
I just got back from Popeye's.
Moves in
Do
that,
you want a bite
that,
of my chicken breath?
Reveal.
Here, puppy. I know you
call him the
today.
Acrobatic improviser, him
Take
and Miles, but you can tell there's a lot more strength, a lot more raw power, aggression, which you saw both in the moves and how Peter talks. So it's not just what happens in gameplay, it's what happens, how the story plays out.
Interesting. So how it affects him as well.
Yeah. I mean, you saw some of that in there's much more of that journey when you play the game.
And I know the journey is also more expansive. You've got Queens, Brooklyn, so even more of sort of
city is pretty much doubled in size. So it's Manhattan, Queens, Brooklyn, and then being able to use the web wings to traverse at speeds way faster than they were before is really awesome.
Hugely ambitious game you guys have been building over the past few years. We saw at the PlayStation event.
I haven't played the first one myself, but I heard these games are really good.
2023, and I think
that's what I heard.
We're like getting close to that. Are you guys feeling confident that you're gonna make it this fall?
Jeff, I know you like exclusives.
Yes.
And I can promise you, we are very confident what we're gonna tell you right now.
Oh. Yeah. Okay. Ooh. Yeah. Let's take a look.
Let's see. No gameplay?
Nailing it. October 20th, Spider-Man 2, exclusively for PlayStation 5.
Got it.
Awesome. Well, Brian, thanks so much for stopping by.
No gameplay?
A lot of work to do. Wrapping up the game, but we'll check it out in October. Thanks, Brian. We got our date. All right. Now let's take a look at Pal World, a multiplayer open-world survival crafting game where you can befriend and collect mysterious creatures called Pal who can also fight. In other words, kind of like Pokemon with guns.
And fuck exclusives.
Then we're going to look at the Land of the Morning Light, a new expansion to Black Desert Online, which recreates the mythical folktales from Korea's Joseon Dynasty, and some huge bosses, too.
No way. Pokemon with guns? Wait, this literally looks like a ripoff. What? Bro? That is a Gundam! Lucario?
What the fuck was that, bro? What the fuck was that? What was that, bro? What the hell? Like...
Long before time had a name.
This is the potential of Pokemon if Nintendo put it on actual good hardware, cap.
That was a Pokemon game. Pokemon gave three fucks about you guys. This looks weird.
Of snow. It is time we told it ourselves.
Is this fucking
with
rock and stone?
Axe, we mine and scout.
Rock and stone
across Middle Earth, delving for riches. Yet the greatest treasure remains out of our reach, Moria.
Well, he's like a ripoff.
Fellow dwarves, rally together. It's time we took back our home.
Lord of the Rings, another mid-game. Another mid-game. I'm sure it's gonna be a good game though, guys. I'm sure. Good man, GTA 6.
All right, now we're going to look at an exciting new mobile game from a legendary franchise.
Mobile game! Looks like I missed nothing. Cool.
Another Final Fantasy game. I want to nuke whoever keeps buying these LTG.
Registration
no,
for
no,
Final
no,
Fantasy
no,
VII
no,
Crisis has just
no,
started,
no,
and
no,
you will
no,
have a chance
no,
to participate
no,
in an upcoming closed beta
no,
test.
No, no,
now,
summer
speaking of Final Fantasy, no, 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 no. Today during Summer Game Fest, DoorDash has your back. Get you can get a free burrito when you order from Taco Bell using the code GAMEFEST. Plus, get the chance to win a Final Fantasy 16 prize pack. DoorDash, stay in your game. Yep, we got you. All right. Now here's a look at the game we debuted last year at TGA.
Games.
Banisher's Ghosts of New Eden, the story of two ghost hunters in the haunted wilds of North America.
Wow.
What's this?
Life to the living, death to the dead. We are banishers. We end suffering for those who live. We bring closure to those who don't. I want us back, Red. I want revenge on what killed me. I want to live.
As the man says, we face a choice, simple and awful.
I banish you. Death to the dead.
Do we kill? To be together again?
Or do we part forever?
Come out, wherever you are. Come on, show yourself.
Red.
Every bloody time.
Red? It's all right, I guess.
それで、 今回の指令は
あなた好みの単純な力仕事です。
ある人物を警護していただきます。 頼みました。
Hello?
大丈夫か?
What the fuck?
お待たせしてしまって。トラブル発生。車はまだか。到着まで3分。何があった？お前らも今回り右すりゃ無事に帰れる。ワンピース。さもなきゃ。これから起きることは全部お前らの選んだ結果だ。
Really, Yakuza game? What the fuck?
Omae no na wa. Ore ni na wa nai.
The man who erased his name. The one book came with this was 16. Thank you, man.
Good morning, Stanley. It is 7:32 a.m. I hope you have a productive day.
Change username to just Stan.
Adjusting morning wake up. Good morning, just Stan.
Base to capsule 12. Come in. You there, Stan?
Green across the board. Looks like we're good.
It looks like Somaya a little bit.
That's from Nautica. Here, Tim.
What? How long has it been now?
3 years. 2 months and 17 days.
What sort of operation are they running down here?
They shouldn't be here.
Someone there?
This doesn't make sense. Someone else down here? No, 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 no.
Dan, are you there?
Under the waves. I don't know how to explain this, but I feel like
it's a beautiful movie. Under the waves are so boring. Today, incidentally, is World Ocean Day.
No.
In fact. All right. Next, Call of Duty. Well, there's a new Call of Duty coming this fall along with Warzone Mobile.
Today,
we're going to give you the first ever look at Season 4 of Modern Warfare 2 Warzone launching next week. Here's your first look at Vondel, a new Warzone location with points of interest, including a medieval castle, a soccer stadium, and an abandoned zoo. Yep. It's all happening. Check it out. Here you go.
I love Call of Duty. Bad.
mean, whatever, if it's better or not, I'll probably play this game, to be honest. I'll probably give it a shot. It's just Call of Duty, man. Like, you don't expect anything from Call of Duty, you know? Like, I expect nothing from Call of Duty, you know? I'm surprised that you guys do.
Season 4, next week. Today is a big day for video games, but also a huge day for Porsche. The iconic German automaker turned 75 years old.
Is the guy just awkwardly standing there on stage
to
these trailers?
The gaming space,
yeah, probably.
All raced a 911 in some point at a game.
911?
Xbox
what?
Has teamed up with Porsche for a limited edition run of 75 consoles inspired by six
famous
Porsche race cars. And I'm thrilled to debut the first design here today, inspired by
it's
the
a car.
Porsche 963
oh,
that's racing
oh.
this weekend. At the 100th running of the 24 hours of
the
Le Mans.
The Porsche 911. Let's take a look. That's a pretty bad name. But whatever, it's their own. Serve to be a second car. Why should it not be called the Porsche 911? Oh wow, it's like a Porsche X Xbox collaboration.
And here it is, the Porsche Xbox Series X. These custom consoles are not for sale, but you can enter for a chance to win one right now at PorscheXboxSweepstakes.com. Make sure to stay tuned for the
They're
Porsche
not
and
for
Xbox
sale?
Social channels for additional opportunities to get your hands on
Been
these
away for
special
a while.
Consoles.
Did you move
All right.
out?
Next,
Plug Independence.
Phoenix Labs are building the next great entry into the cozy farm sim genre. We all like a cozy game inspired by classics like Animal Crossing and Stardew Valley. Previously
wow.
announced for Nintendo Switch, there's now some exciting news for PC players too.
Wow.
Let's take a look at Fae Farm.
Dear friend, life in Azoria's been treating me well. Days pass so quickly. Before I know it, they turn into seasons. It's been a breath of fresh air. I think we found a way to get cozy and settle in. But there's something more I've been itching to explore.
These books.
Realms where magic comes to meet us. As long as we're prepared, we can face anything. So, what do you say? There's so much yet to discover. Are you ready?
We promise variety. There it is. Fae Farm and Mortal Kombat in the same show, only at Summer Game Fest. Now, please welcome Ben Brode, Chief Dang. Development Officer and flannel enthusiast at Second Dinner, the developers behind the popular collectible card game Marvel Snap. What's up, Ben? Man, you guys have been on fire. Last time I saw you was at the Game Awards when you won Best Mobile Game. Seems like you've been very busy. We're excited about the Spider-Verse content you've been doing. Lots going on over there, right?
Yeah, it's been exciting. We've been doing a bunch of new features, some of the wildest cards we've ever made, and
wow,
some new game modes. Yeah.
is that a segue, Ben?
Certainly. Yeah, I'm excited to announce Marvel Snap's biggest update ever. We have a new game mode coming next week. It's Conquest mode. It's a great way to get a super competitive experience.
Why is he talking like that?
Some exciting
Why
new rewards.
Why is he talking like that?
But you don't have to wait till next week. If you haven't tried Marvel Snap, go download it right now on your mobile device or early access on Steam.
All right, Ben. I love the enthusiasm, Ben.
That's what I got.
That's you. You're made for YouTube. All right. Well, we heard you brought something fun with you for us to watch, right?
Oh, yeah. So, listen. I am incredible at card games, so I often win.
Wow.
But some people, and maybe you've had this experience, Jeff, some people lose.
Yeah.
Bro sniffed fair. Some lines before this.
And I like to think
this.
It's because they suck. No offense, Jeff. Awesome. But sometimes,
yes.
Sometimes it's because they might just be
yes.
A little bit unlucky.
Cue the tape.
Oh, snap.
Okay, I don't have an ideal hand of cards here, but that's fine. I'll see what I draw in future turns. Anyway, let's reveal the first location.
Lamuntis 1. Each player destroys their deck.
Okay, I guess I will work with what I have. I'll play Medusa on location number 2. She gets +2 power. And let's see the next location.
Clover Dangerfield has a 25% chance of destroying your cow.
Okay, well, I mean, 25% isn't that bad. And it's gone. Okay, well, I have some powerful cards in my hand, so I can just wait. Let's see the next location.
The Big Barn. Players cannot play 4, 5, or 6 cost cows.
You gotta be kidding me.
Also, if you don't play a card this turn, you have 0 friends.
Nah, you're just being mean.
2012 humor ain't in a way.
Still to come, we're going to look at Immortals of Avium from EA Originals and Ascendant and the world premiere first look at Chapter 4, Season 3 of Fortnite Wilds. Now, if you're looking for the smartest way to level up your gaming this summer, compare top cards side by side with your wallet and start maximizing your cash back.
Holy shit, that was a little bit too cringe.
From Wi-Fi to headsets. Now, here's a look at King Arthur Legends Rise, a new cross-platform UE5 game for mobile and PC, a fantasy squad.
I like those guys. I like that guy's costume, but that was
life
cringe.
Is pain.
Athena dies of cringe.
I like that guy's content, but I feel like that one was so forced.
Arthur, I have sacrificed everything to save your kind.
They were keeping his family at gunpoint. Do the fucking ass! I don't want to do it, pussy!
Fight with honor. Vanquish the wicked.
I'll do it too, bro. I'll do something great for money too. Fuck it, man.
Of your legacy.
We ball. All I'm saying is the Batches guy carried the show. I haven't laughed that hard in a while. Jesus, man. Wow! Mortals now! Lizards! That's crazy! I'm gonna show you some new cards! Like, dude, oh my god, man.
Do you remember the fall?
I was dying.
The gloom descended on Skylight. You
is this a new game? Or is this the same game from last trailer?
Choice. You fell, and the world was broken. Remember who you were, who you are, and return to us. This world needs champions.
Wayfinder. This looks like Valorant, to be honest. Valorant meets medieval shit. Oh, Fortnite, don't worry!
This world needs more heroes in a way.
Wow.
Humans, bow at the feet of your future emperor or face annihilation.
Steve, seriously? You don't stand a chance.
Project under construction.
What is this?
What did you say, guys? One more game?
Good morning, scavenger. Scan your surroundings to retrieve and recycle anything that could be of value to Scavex.
A space stretch scavenger.
Captain's log. Stardate 43152.4.
Oh. Wait.
Our fleet is cautiously entering hostile territory. And the crew is standing by.
We are the Borg. Lower your shields and surrender your ships. Your culture will adapt to service us. Resistance is futile.
The Big Bang Theory. Shut the fuck up, bro. A whole universe.
Hey there, Summer Game Fest 2023. It's Will Arnett here. Yeah, right? My buddy Anthony Mackie and I have been working on this for some time now. We're really excited to share with you Twisted Metal, which is streaming only on Peacock what? Starting July 27th. And I'm very excited to share a sneak peek of the character of Sweet Tooth, who I had the pleasure of voicing. Hope you enjoy it. Check it out.
I mean, fuck it. Believe it or not, that was the only thing that has left an impact on me. I don't know what the game's about.
In order to multitask, this new hack and slash game with a tactical twist allows you to do just that.
But brought like,
to you
look cool.
From France, here's the world premiere reveal trailer of Lisfanga, the time shift warrior, coming later this year.
Lisfanga? Wait, is that a game? Lisfanga.
Goddess of time.
Receive my light, Lisfanga. Let Lisfanga. This power flow through you.
That's gonna be the worst fucking name ever.
Alongside your past selves.
I'm here no again. Have another me.
I look good.
I rewind, I begin again, but with another me to fight with.
You're coming with me!
This type of games are so, like, 2020, you know? No, 2010, you know?
I will become Legion.
Maybe it's good, though. Maybe it's good, though, for right now, but it's like... I don't know, Lisfanga.
Onwards. I can feel that there are more.
Very cool independent game. All right, next up is a brand new IP
cool.
from Ascendant Studios, a single player, first person magic shooter called Immortals of Avium. It's fast and fluid. It's an FPS in a fantasy setting, kind of like Doom with magic. It also has a great cast led by Darren Barnett as the main character, Jack, and he joins us now. Hey, Darren.
Hey, guys.
Great to have you with
How's
us.
Doing? Thank you.
This Very is excited. Such a cool game, super high production value, spectacular gameplay. Tell us about the guy you play. You're the main character, Jack, right?
Yes, I am playing the main character, Jack, as seen behind me. He's a battle mage that controls all three forms of magic, triple threat. He's brash, he's funny, but he gets the job done.
Well, it's the gameplay, as we've seen, is just so fast-paced. There's so much action in it, you know, with all the spells, the spell casting, and the magic. What can you tell us about the story and sort of how this battle mage, Jack, comes in? He sort of becomes a battle mage, right?
Yeah, he kind of comes from nothing. He's, I guess they call him a street rat is what he was. But he, yeah.
Surely there won't be more Marvel ones. Ha, ha, ha.
Summons the power to control magic.
Yeah, he
becomes part
nothing.
Of the Immortals, which is like the elite Navy SEAL squad of this world called Avium, and they are in the middle of an ever war fighting for the control of magic.
Okay.
I have no idea what he's saying. I only heard Tom and I laugh.
Lots of amazing actors in this incredible, really high production value game that's coming out this summer.
I
wait long for
no clue what he said.
I know
I just heard Tom and I laugh.
With you to share today, which is a gameplay sequence, which is one of the most epic sort of parts of the game, right?
Yeah. So this is a wild part of the game. This trailer is going to be showing you the Immortals and myself confronting Sandrak directly, who is the top villain
Bro,
of this game,
of these games
and trying to end the Everwar. And it's taking place in like one of the most badass levels of a video game I've seen. We're battling on top of a 400-foot mech in the middle of the ocean as it moves around. It's wild, so let's take a look.
All right, let's take a look at some brand new gameplay from Immortals
of Avium.
The
first thing I hear is a
PC,
Marvel
PS5,
one-liner
Xbox.
Where they show the Thank fucking... Gate, try it, I'm gonna fucking shoot myself.
Sandrax literally pushed us to the edge. Everyone that can fight already is. And we're still losing.
Please don't say it. Don't say that, the one-liner, please.
Aboard, immortal. What's our bearing, sir?
North by northeast, 5 knots.
We'll catch him, sir.
You see, the same fucking shit nobody cares about.
Did I just move the laser by ambush?
Next year, let's do a stream where we each take a shot of rum every time there's a one-liner.
Holy. Holy. That looks so wonky. Dude. This looks exact. Like, dude, I just, man. Like, I can't help but feel like I've seen this game 1,000 times already. In some way.
No way, doom guy with magic.
Dude, the Bifrit's dying. Well, the guy who's playing the game can't aim for shit, bro.
I want to be an immortal. I want to fight this war as one of you.
You're what's called a Triarch.
A Triarch?
Khorasan has gifted you with the ability to manifest all three colors of magic.
We're only going to win this one together. Sigil up.
Like I said, mid.
Love
just
that
mid.
Thank you guys so much for amazing
mid
raw gameplay today, and that game looks incredible. Coming out this
just
summer
mid
from Ascendant and EA.
No way,
now, one
Skyrim
game that
game
constantly
play
reinvents itself is Fortnite. And tomorrow, Chapter 4 of Season 3 Wilds launches. And
it's
today, Summer Game Fest is debuting the cinematic trailer to preview the season. The center of the island has collapsed, revealing a vast hidden jungle with ancient secrets to discover. And of course, there's a whole new Battle Pass lineup where you can unleash the power,
Fortnite,
yes, of Cybertron. Here we go.
Transformers? Optimus Prime. Holy. New vehicle. Oh yeah, you're right. Probably.
Oh,
Optimus Prime! What the fuck? Yeah, do we sick if, like, do people still care about Transformers?
Fortnite Wilds launches tomorrow. Well, finally, guys, it's time to get to our grand finale.
No?
And it is a deep honor for me to present this game. What you're about to see is a world premiere trailer that gives us a new look at an expansive world we can't wait to explore again.
GTA 6?
This game comes from a studio that surprised the world and redefined the RPG genre with its iconic characters and rich storytelling. And I want to thank them for this trailer for one of gaming's most anticipated upcoming releases. The rumors were true.
Persona?
We're still here at the scene of this terrible disaster caused by a massive tornado which swept through sectors 0, 1, and 2. Amidst the wreckage of the expressway, search and rescue operations are already in progress.
Oh my god, another Final Fantasy!
Just
fuck me, bro! I don't give a shit about Final Fantasy! I'm so tired of this stupid franchise! I see it every year! I don't care!
It may look that way, but in reality, it's barely hanging on.
I was wondering, what's Cloud been doing these past
five
years?
If I can fuck the girl, then I'm not interested in that. I'm sorry. Simple as that.
Asking me this? This is gonna sound crazy, but as far as I know, Cloud was never in Nibelheim 5 years ago.
If there's no Cloud sex mod, I'm not interested, bro.
Life stream. It is the very essence of our star.
Square Enix, when they release the same-looking game every fucking year and making it look like it's game-changing.
According to Hojo, they're connected to Sephiroth. Shadows of the Man, I believe he called them.
Sephiroth was in mid-
After 17 games, they should honestly kill themselves now.
He's alive.
But why come back now? After 5 years, doing who knows what.
Well now, think we woke it up.
Angered it, more like.
Dude, like, man, can someone explain to me?
The Turk's latest and greatest, Elena.
She may be new, but she's still a Turk.
Dude.
The crazy thing is, I don't give a fuck!
No way another Final Fantasy, the same game in the last year's been.
Can someone explain to me, like, the Final Fantasy lore? How many times have I seen this cat this game?
Why does Tifa have clothes on? Is the video bugged?
Shut up, dumbass. Shut up, bro. Can someone explain to me?
Gentlemen, masturbation session starts earlier than expected. Please have your cocks ready in 10 minutes.
Into the very depths of your soul. That she can become those you hate. Those you fear. Those you love.
You murdered my dad!
Can someone explain to me? I'm almost certain that I've seen this game 3 times. Am I crazy?
That I killed her. So, who is she?
They live in a fantasy where the shitty franchise will finally end.
There you have it. That was Final Fantasy VII Rebirth coming early 2024 to PlayStation 5.
Medic, charge me now!
All right. That's going to do it for Summer Game Fest, our live showcase. But that is not the end
of
Summer Game Fest. Stay tuned this weekend for updates on many more games during SGF Play Days, a hands-on event for media here in Los Angeles, including Cyberpunk 2077, Phantom Liberty, as well as the Xbox and Bethesda showcase on Sunday. Right now, though, stay tuned for Day of the Devs from I Am 8-Bit and Double Fine, which celebrates
is there more tomorrow, Chatters?
A number of new game reveals over the
next hour. Is there more tomorrow?
We'll see you this summer, later this summer, on August 22nd for Gamescom Opening Night Live in Germany, and again in December when we come together here in Los Angeles to celebrate 10 years of the Game Awards. Thanks for watching, everyone. We'll see you soon.
Dude, fuck me, man. I got my hopes up for fucking nothing.
Would you rather finish Final Fantasy or One Piece?
One Piece is shorter, bro. Trust me. Believe it or not. If you read it, it's faster. To be honest, games that I'm looking forward to, Alan Wake. That's like the number one game I'm looking forward to. Alan motherfucking Wake. It's the only game that looked interesting to me. Every other game looked really boring. I'm not gonna lie. Now, here's a question. Can someone fill me in, Chatters? What the fuck is this? The hell? Aliens?
Type of sex mode now for the love god!
Looks good, maybe I'll check it out tomorrow.
Probably the only good-looking games for me were Alan Wake 2 and Yakuza Gaiden for real.
True! Okay, so here's a question. Is there new shit tomorrow, Chatters, or when's the new shit? When's the new shit? What other days are we seeing new shit? Can someone fill me in? I don't care about this, sadly. Is here the link? So on June 8th, we got the Summer Fest. No one gives a fuck. Tribes Game Spotlight. Is Tribe Game Spotlight any worth it, Chatters, or no? No?
Bob, man.
No? So what days would you guys like to see? What days we see? We could check out this tomorrow, but eh. Probably the Xbox one? The Xbox one for sure. Right? For sure. June 10th too? Future games too? What about a little PC gaming show? No? Do you guys care about Tribeca Game Spotlight? Yes or no? No? Do you guys care about Wholesome Direct? Indie games demonstrate the incredible range of teams and styles. No, right? Not really? ODK Game Expo? I'm assuming no one gives a shit. Look at it, times two. 9 a.m.
Bro, Final Fantasy looks like the corpse. Devs can't stop fucking. Or anyone, really. Enjoy this games.
What about future game show? Summer Case. A showcase over 50 multi-format games. This is good, right? It's not be worth it. This is different for sure. For Xbox, for sure, I'll stream the Xbox thing. The PC gaming show. Maybe? I don't know. Ubisoft Showcase was next live in Los Angeles? No. And maybe Capcom? I don't know. For sure, I'll check out the Xbox one, though. For sure, I'll check out the Xbox one.
MP Hop.
And the Future Games one, yeah. Well, so what do you guys think? What would you guys rate the event from? This game looks cool though. I wanna test it out. Look at this. Well, I gotta check this out for tomorrow. What do you guys thought of the thing? Like 10 out of 10? Like 10 out of 3? I mean 10, 3 out of 10. Ooh. 5 out of 10? I mean, it had like some... The thing is, like, it had... Okay, no. Here's the thing. It had some good games. The problem is that, like... A lot of the games that are announced... Here's the thing. There was three options. Either medieval garbage looks the same, or... It was either medieval garbage looks the same, or... Straight up, like, fantasy bullshit that it kind of looks the same, too. And it's just Squidward. Sorry, my bad. That means removing my community post. There we go. I don't really care about Final Fantasy either, to be honest. Okay, well, that was 44 down. Now, chatters, for the main game of today's stream. We got Q Remastered. Apparently, from what I heard, it's actually a good game. Apparently, it's a really fun game. It's about puzzles. No way.
Hey, Red, unsure if you have played this before, but could you stream Half-Life the original at some point? Also, a new game that is out is called Astro Colony, and it's actually pretty fun. Otherwise, can't wait for some new games.
Surely. Surely. Oh. What the fuck? Okay, let's do Q Remastered. Oh, yeah, good title. Yeah, some games look good though. I mean, I'm a hater to the core because I'm just the way it is. But some games look good. I saw this game though. This game looked interesting. It's like a fucking what's it called? Like a puzzle game or whatever the hell. What the fuck is this? Yeah, it's like an IQ test. How's the audio though? Is that fine? Lower, higher? Lower? What about there? Is that better? Huh. Is that fine? All right. Let's see. Okay, hold on. So where do I put my camera so it's not annoying the fuck out of me? Maybe bottom right, maybe? Changes. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's an IQ test, by the way. It's an actually IQ test. Okay, let's see. Top right is better. Alright, I trust each other. Let's see.
You have something in the space below. Move the cursor by moving the mouse. Draw what brings the mouse.
You did it.
What the fuck? A tutorial, no way. Draw something that. Draw something and have it touch the red ball. To redo, hold right click. Oh, I see.
You did it.
Oh. Alright. To touch the left wall of the, with the ball. So like this. Huh? Oh, the left one. Just kidding. It made sense. It made sense though, because the left of the left. Okay, now it's making. The left of this. No. Touch the left wall with your drawing. Draw a stick and let it drop. Draw a slope and let something roll on it. Touch the left wall with your drawing. Draw a stick and let it drop. Hey! New question has appeared. Press any button. What? Touch the left wall with your drawing. I thought I did this, no?
You did it.
Wait, didn't I do this? Oh. Take the ball out. Like this? What? Oh, I have an idea. Huh? Yeah, easy.
You did it.
Chill, bro. I know what I'm doing. Make the ball touch the left wall. What? We can't see? That's better. Oh. Wait, we did this. Make the ball touch the left wall.
I'm not gonna sugarcoat it. I think you are retarded.
No, man, it's harder. Dude!
Sorry, he's pretending for content!
Dude! Oh!
You did it.
Relax! Make the ball touch the left wall? Oh. Dude!
You wouldn't lie to us. Right, chat. Right.
Shut up. No! No!
Guys, I don't think he's pretending anymore.
Shut up, bro. I did it. I got it. Thanks. Do something and touch the red area. What? Oh, wait. I got it.
This is what we does to your brain, fellas!
Dude, I'm trying my best, shut up!
Oh my god, he's evolving, chat! His brain is not that tinny anymore!
Oh, wait! Ah! Oh, fuck. I got it. Then... I forgot to add the ball. Here we go. Make it bigger.
Hi, Mr. Redshell and Chat Red's Flower.
Oh, maybe you don't have to do a triangle.
I think you might be the first person ever to fail the IT test.
It's bugged! Unless the key of this is to make the ship bigger. Like this. Ah.
Not even close, Kick.
Here we have a wild-eyed Dart, suffering because he was dropped as a baby.
Dude! What do I do? What do I do? It's not easy! Unless, it's gotta be an easier way.
Richel, you are not just a regular Morin, you are designed to be a Morin.
He's actually getting worse, holy fuck.
Unless... Hold on.
Let's just draw the line at the top.
Oh, wait, no, I get it. I actually get it. Wait.
Skill issue.
Did anyone ever tell you the definition of insanity?
It was easy!
You did it.
Okay. Easy, bro, easy. Put 5 balls in the blade below. It can't be done.
Holy shit! You are not smarter than a fifth grader. Wally!
Can be done heavy if drawn. No. I figured it wouldn't work. Okay, so all we need is something here bigger. Okay, more.
You were dropped as a child.
Okay. Oh wait, what if I... No, I get it. Okay. What if I draw like a hook? What do I do? It doesn't work! Can be done heavily if drawn personally at some point.
How about you draw some extra brain cells for yourself?
What if?
What if I make a streamer is not very smart, Red Scree.
What if I make a cogwheel?
Are you special needs?
Oh!
Once again.
Rich, you'll just draw at the same point, at the same place again and again. Please, we love you.
Legalize imaginary marriages.
Shut up, man. Let me focus. What if I draw a triangle?
Retro, this is the ninth stage. You can't be this stupid.
Can be done heavily if drawn precisely in the same point. What does that mean? Wait. I don't get it. What does that mean? What does can be done heavily if drawn at the same point? Draw in the same place, so what, like this? Oh, wait. Almost done, hold on. Is it infinite though? Is it infinite though?
You did it.
Easy. Easy. Easy, bro. Wasn't it hard? Take the ball out?
Red Shell was definitely the kid who thought 2 plus 2 equals 22.
Let's charge it. Unless the key is to put something here.
Schizophrenic episode incoming. Hey, one.
I want to apologize for Red Shell. Sorry for accusing you of throwing for content before. You are just truly retarded.
doesn't make any sense. How does this work? Unless the key is to make it long.
Clueless, actually.
Wait. What if we hold on, hold on. Dude, it's not possible. It's bugged. Unless okay, we gotta get like a super ball. We gotta charge it. So close!
Watching this makes me believe that the apocalypse is less of a fear and more of a hope.
Shut up, we're almost done.
Insanity is doing the same thing over and over and expecting different results.
It's bugged! Unless the plan is to not...
Feels dank, man.
I get it. I have an idea. Music suck ass? Wait, is there even music for levels or no? Guys, we gotta finish it. Take the ball out. Man, do I just not get it? Oh, what if it's a triangle? Like a heavy triangle. Oh, wait.
I used to think I was stupid, but after seeing this, I can honestly say I'm proud of myself for not being at this level of stupidity.
I know you haven't eaten today. Take a bite.
Melon.
Oh, let me cook, I got this. I'm gonna try for a while. Dude, what am I supposed to do? Unless the plan is to make a triangle here. Hold on. I think I get it. No, I actually get it. I already theory crafted in my head. Trust me. Oh.
It's like watching a caveman evolve in real time.
You guys are just jealous. I'm about to fucking break the code. Well, what if we put another triangle here? And then Watch. Wait. What if I put a triangle here? Believe me, this is it. This is actually it. Trust.
I just got out of my job for today and tuned into stream to try and relax. But after seeing this, I think I would rather go back to my job.
Oh yeah? Well, your mother. What's this? I told you, loser! I knew it! I knew I could do it! In the same, can we change the music? Fine. We'll do video game music. Make the ball
press. But please take an IQ test on stream. I genuinely think you're in the double digits.
Make the ball touch the left wall. That's easy. See, bro? Relax, guys.
Be honest with us, Rachel. Were you motivated to draw whatever abomination you are drawing right now after watching another Bob Ross video?
Raise Alex. That's easy, another stick man. Look at this.
Stop throwing stick men, they do not work.
Oh yeah, they do not work, look at this, pussy! Fuck you! Draw something and touch the red area. Hmm. Okay, this time for sure though. And I'm gonna make it really heavy. Like, what do I do? Oh, wait. What if I do like something like Sonic? Hold on. This. Okay, the idea was there. The idea was there, though. Like, how do I make it? How do I do this? It doesn't make any sense unless... Oh. Okay. Then we do another triangle. Okay. And then... So close! No!
Round one.
Fight. Ah! It's fine, it's fine.
Choose your destiny. Flawless victory. Choose your destiny.
Another triangle. It doesn't work, it's bugged.
Excellent. Okay.
Oh, hey, there we go. Fuck you. Get that ass down. Yeah, action takes for 60 bounds, thank you, man. Make the ball touch the ground. I'm that guy. New quiz appeared. No! Again?
In decades of doing these tests, I have never seen someone so proficient and quick-witted, breezing through anything that is thrown their way. Let's check on Ridshell now.
Relax, I'm getting it, boys. Hold on, I can save this. What do I do then? I got this. Oh, I get it. I get it. I get it. Oh, wait, I learned. I have gathered new information. It's just not possible. Oh, maybe I have to make a really tight.
Feel free to click on this subscribe button, see if you got a Twitch Prime sub available, huh?
Kick.
Well, I think I got it. I tried, don't worry. I got it. Chill, man. Chill.
Oh, he's red. She'll make it tight.
Okay, I can solve this. But how? I need to make it super heavy. Oh, wait! Oh. Wait, I can make the triangle here! Wait!
Plays video games for a living, by the way.
It needs a triangle, but maybe lower this time. Like this. Chill. I got this. Like this. Trust, believe. Or what if I were to draw the path? No. Give me a second, man. I'm trying my best. Oh, for fuck's sake. Oh, wait. No. Give me a second, bro. This will work, trust. We don't have enough power, bro. unless it's not possible, dude. It's just not. Maybe the triangle should be bigger, maybe. Hold on.
Triangle gaming.
Oh, wait. What if I were to do this? So, like, it cuts with the triangle. Hold up. Okay, then you guys don't even know how to either. You're shitting on me when you yourselves don't even know how to do it either. So shut up.
Who let him cook?
I know how to do. All you have to do is...
triangle, man.
Stop pretending now.
Well, maybe I don't need a triangle. Maybe I need a ramp. No. Like this? Hold on. Oh. Oh wait, I think I know how to. The Stickman straps. Okay, wait, no wait, I had a good point, hold on.
Ridshaw, the answer is...
Please make it stop!
Oh! It doesn't make any sense! How do I do this? How?
Stop drawing triangle, for fuck's sake! Your name coming!
Wait, hold on. What if I were to do more... Wait. Like a box. So then... Guys!
What is he cooking?
A club today!
Send a Stickman dead for this shit!
I got this, chill bro. Oh?
Draw a hat and a big horizontal line already!
No, it's not possible, bro. A way like this? I got this. Like this.
You are the reason shampoo has instructions.
Dude, it's not as easy as it looks like, man. Then...
I need healing.
Wait.
All you gotta do is, with the, then from there you, and that's it.
What you doing is called vertical, just do it horizontal.
Dude, it's not gonna work. Why, like this is not gonna work. Wait. How is that gonna help, dumbasses? Oh, no. Maybe the last will be longer. Wait. What if?
Make a 3/4 run on the ball thing and fill it. It.
Do you know who you are when you speak your words?
This? Oh? But then we need a triangle here. Ah, I get it.
Richelle is the complete opposite of that kid who explained the fourth dimension.
For the first time, I want to buy a game just to prove myself I'm not retarded.
Oh, wait! Shit, but yes! Easy! Suck my dick, idiots! The triangle always works!
The Omnics declare war. The nations of the world had no answer. Until they called upon a small group of humans. Overwatch was created to rescue humanity from the atomic crisis. We became the greatest champions of peace and progress mankind has ever seen.
This is why they test these games on lab rats first.
It's a bad goddamn time.
Yeah, a second, I'm gonna think. Like this, wait. I don't get it! What did I do wrong? Unless...
If you shoot myself, please, Red Shell.
You aren't just a regular Morin. You were designed to be a Morin.
Hold on.
You should have stayed in law school.
I got it.
Oh my fucking god, please!
Wait! A triangle. Hear me out. Can't you see? Hear me out, actually. Oh fuck, I did it wrong.
Where does this walk look? That's not crowd.
Okay, guys. While we are watching Rachel struggling with balls and triangles, I teach you how to tie Heyman's knots step by step. Step past the peg, and then the shape made with the rope. Second step! Wrap it around the upper loop in the standing part.